It's been a long year. I know you're tired and you're blue. You've been breathing smoke inside this trial of fire, but you got through. And I know the world's gone wrong, but you're still present, you're still strong. Hold
on. Good morning, friends, and welcome to another painting stream. Hello, everybody. I'm Andrew, also known as Tanatoes, and this is my mostly daily painting stream. Give me a couple of seconds. I am just sending out notifications that I'm live so that people know to tune in. And then we'll get some painting done. If you were not here yesterday, I finally did finish work on all the last minis from the War Cry demo that I've been working on. So now it's on to working on some of the terrain. I've got some small terrain pieces that we're sort of messing around with. We got a good start on some of them yesterday. We'll continue to work on them today. And then perhaps we'll move on to some of the larger terrain pieces. I don't know. Yeah, I'm sort of making it up as I go along. Anyhow. Let me boop. Just post in a couple of places. And here. There we go. So the horrible, horrible heat has finally broken here where I live at, and it is actually quite pleasant now. So that's good. I'll take it, you know? It's the small things. Slightly less awful heat, progress on the minis. Yesterday, the store that I work at got in the new Age of Sigmar Dominion box, which is the starter box for Age of Sigmar 3.0, the new Warhammer Fantasy. And I started assembling that. It's got 30 models in it, and I got 6.5 done yesterday in a full shift. Of course, this is between customers and stuff, so, you know, I'm pulling orders for Magic customers, and I'm helping people at the register and answering the phone, and between all of that, I'm building minis. So, I don't know. I wish I could have made more progress, but I did all right. Got about half of the Stormcast Eternal figures done. Haven't started on the orcs. They're going to be a lot of fun. Anyways, I am not planning to paint those on stream. I'm hardly planning to paint them at all. But assembling them, oh man, they're just gorgeous. And I can't help wanting to do something with them. But in the meantime, let's go over here to Zoom Cam and take a look at these tiny little terrain pieces. So we have these two wall pieces, one of which I've gotten a good start on. I painted all the pillars and stuff, and then I did a wash on it. You can see this is what it looked like before I did the wash, and this is after the wash. So we're going to do a wash on the other side of that. This one I haven't done anything except prime it, so it needs a lot of work. I've got these two little fountain pieces, one of which I've got a wash on and one of which I don't. So I'm going to do a wash on that today. Yep. Making progress. And then I've got these two little piles of debris. and I want to sort of play around with those. So we'll start working on those today. Get some color in there. So those are the six pieces I'm hoping to get done in the next couple of days. I'm looking at this little piece to see what colors I'm probably going to want. I want to mess around with these little broken vases, amphorae. So we'll play around with those a little bit. Obviously, some skulls. There's some sort of bare dirt, so we'll go in and get that. Maybe I'll start with that today, because that's something fun to play with. We'll start with the dirt that's in the background there. I'm going to use flat earth, which is what I used for the dirt on the Chaotic Beasts armies that I was painting yesterday. God, I cannot express what a relief it is that it is actually fairly pleasant that the weather is no longer super hot here. That was just so unbearable. This is obviously going to have a lot of... I'm going to do a wash on all this at some point. So, just... can be kind of messy. Sort of little rocks and stones in here too, so we'll color those gray, I suppose. So for these broken piece of crockery, I kind of want to do them in different colors and maybe play around with adding some illustrations to them. Just as something fun to mess around with. I'm hoping that getting all these little terrain pieces is not going to take a huge amount of time. We'll see. Got four large terrain pieces, one of which I've already gotten a start on. And those might take a little bit longer to get done. We'll see. I don't know if you remember yesterday I talked about getting some flocking so I could do something that looks like moss growing on some of the pieces that I'm working on, some of the small terrain. So I did do that. I picked up some flocking from work. So we'll play around with that a little today, I hope. This is not going to be too busy
kind of, there's going to be a lot of little details of this, but hopefully it will read quickly to the eye. I don't even know what the relevance is of this as terrain. I don't think it's much of a barrier. It's not going to provide cover. It's just sort of a little lump that'll sit on the battlefield from a mechanics perspective. I don't think it has much impact on the game. But it's fun to paint. And you all know that's what I'm all about, is having fun painting things. There's that. Let's do this one. These are obviously identical. They're just the same exact mold. I'm gonna try and make them look as if they're two separate pieces by painting the broken crockery slightly differently between the two of them. Up at all hours last night, meowing and racing from window to window. I think she must have seen some form of wildlife outside. She was certainly a wild thing this morning, with the result that I woke up fairly early and couldn't really get back to sleep. I don't blame her. And honestly, even with the little amount of sleep that I got, I feel like I slept better than I have in at least a week. I feel more rested. So I've started making plans for another painting project. I guess I'm always sort of thinking about painting project plans, triple P. But I've been thinking about Marvel crisis protocol, because I have quite a lot, well, not a lot, but I have several crisis protocol figures that I picked up, not to play, but just to paint, as I kind of wanted to paint them. I've got Spider-Man and I think what they call Ghost Spider, which is Miles Morales and Gwen. So I've got those to paint. And I've got a bunch of Black Panther minis. And I was thinking about, not for the spider folk, but for all the Black Panther stuff, doing a diorama. I kind of want to see if I can make a backdrop based on the Land of the Ancestors from the movie. So with that sort of purple hue. But if I was going to do that, I think I would want to build some trees. So that would be a cool new skill to work on. Means getting myself some wire that I can use in the construction of trees. That is perhaps a larger project, but something to mess around with someday. I think I would also want, if I was building trees, to get a hold of a panther figure. I feel like Bones or WizKids make a panther for D&D, so maybe I can get a hold of a panther that I can put in the branches of the tree that I build for that diorama. I've also got these sort of terrain pieces for Underworld that I built and primed forever ago that might be fun to paint, so I might work on those someday. Always thinking of fun new projects to do. Alright. I'm gonna work on this, all the pillars on this here. And we're doing that in deck tan. Got two bottles of deck tan, and I don't know which of them is the newer one. I knew it was a color that I was going to be using a lot, so I bought spare. Fast with this stuff, because you can beat bubbles into the paint and then it's a pain to get them back out. I still can't believe I finished all the war cry set. There were times when it felt insurmountable. Just so many minis to paint. But I guess sitting down and doing a little painting every day, eventually you're gonna finish something, right? So I think with this I need to paint one side and then let that side dry before I flip it over and paint the other side. Oh my goodness, look at this. Look. Jack, can you see how many little bubbles are in there? Where's it all coming from? I don't usually have this much trouble. It's either my brush has become splayed and is holding on to air, which is then getting into the paint, or the paint is thinner than normal. Shake the paint up enough. Just a throwaway small terrain piece, but I'd rather not have it look like I was being sloppy when I was painting it. Peaceful morning. Obviously, I'm going to be doing a very liberal wash on this later, so. Doesn't have to be perfect. Do a wash on the other side. That I did a wash on yesterday, this one here. I'll do a wash on the other side of that as soon as I'm done with what I'm doing here. Came to the sense, the hunt is my muse. feel like these little terrain pieces will probably keep me occupied for the remainder of this week. It's Wednesday already, right? Wednesday. Where does the time go? Means today is D&D day at Battleground Abington. I'm anticipating 4 tables today of D&D players. Trying to sort of roll it out slowly. I don't want the whole store just full of people all at once. Trying to be safe about things. But there is a huge pent-up demand for D&D in the store. People just want their D&D. And I can't say I blame them. Someday soon, we're going to have to start rolling out Learn to Play D&D. That's the most requested thing, I think. Our Beginner Magic and Learn to Play D&D. It's what people most want in the store. Number 3 right now is Pokemon tournaments, which have been very much put on hold because obviously a large portion of the target audience for Pokemon tournaments still can't get vaccinated. I think it's going to be a little while before we can hold Pokemon in the store again, which is disappointing for a lot of people, but it's all, you know. We're being cautious. We're trying to be safe. And I realize a lot of people seem to believe that things are all better now. We've got vaccines. Everything's okay. Well, yeah, some people can get vaccinated. Children can't. And children are who plays Pokemon. There's a lot of collectors out there these days. But the actual players tend to be on the younger side. So a lot of those people currently can't get vaccinated. And I'm a little worried about the rise of the Delta variant. We all know it's more virulent and causes hospitalizations to a larger number of people and has more of an impact on younger people. So all of that's pretty terrible. Like, for the fully vaccinated, supposedly Delta, you know, you're never going to have 100% efficacy in a vaccine. But supposedly, for the fully vaccinated, Delta is less deadly. Like, it prevents hospitalizations still 100% of the time. So far. But, like I said, there's a lot of unvaccinated children out there. And when Delta starts taking off, not going to be great. Well. So, all of this is to say, Learn to Play D&D is coming, but we'll probably have some restrictions. And the same for Learn to Play Magic. Right now, D&D we can do in the store because that's an older crowd and it seems the vast majority of our D&D players and DMs are fully vaccinated, which is good. So that's progress. Higher level magic tournaments. Again, the vast majority of our modern magic crowd and even our EDH crowd are fully vaccinated now. We're lucky to be here in Massachusetts, where the vaccination rates are fairly high. When vaccinations opened up in Massachusetts, a lot of people took advantage of that, and I'm very pleased with that. Pokemon is going to be a while. A lot of the learn to play stuff is going to be a while. Sad fact of living in pandemic times. This is coming along pretty quickly, right? It's a brand new American dream for me and you. Trying to be precise, but not super slow. A sort of blend of precision and speed. Because I've got, when I'm done with all these tiny terrain pieces, there's quite a lot of larger terrain pieces to work on. And it's going to be a lot of this, where I'm just doing pillars and stuff like that. So this is good practice. Want to go a little bit faster when we get to that. when I'm done with this side of this, we'll go do the wash on the other side of the other wall that we've got. Is to hold this without getting my fingers too paint covered. I mean, it looks cool, right? Putting my hand down in the paint. It's perfect. Fiddly bit of this is doing these little stormcast eternal lightning symbols. The teeth. Done. Okay. These little tiny terrain pieces, I get a sense of variety because I'm doing a bunch of different things, doing pillars and stonework, but I'm also doing skulls. I've got a bunch of skulls to paint. I've got I just did some brown earth. Because these things are so small, it's sort of like painting minis. I've got a lot of details and I sort of have to choose which details I'm going to pay attention to and highlight, and which details I allow to sort of fade into the background. I made the right choice with these when I decided not to paint the individual bricks. It's just more trouble than it's worth. I can do a quick dry brush to highlight the bricks after I've done the wash. Thank you, Lobster. Yeah, the bricks look fine after the wash. Because the wash gets down into the crevices and highlights them. And then, yeah, like I said, I can go in and do a quick dry brush to give them a little bit of definition. I think with something like this, with terrain, I need to concentrate more on easy tricks to get stuff done faster. Because otherwise I'll be painting terrain for the rest of my life. I want to get the terrain out of the way and done so I can go on to other projects. Especially these tiny, inconsequential terrain bits that may not get much use. Might not hit the table as frequently. They'll look cute in, like, pictures. Like, if I want to pose the armies, having some small terrain is cool. But I don't know how practical this stuff is. That time, didn't I? That's one side of this wall done. I'm going to put it down to dry. And let's put a wash on the other side of this wall. And we'll do a wash on this fountain, because I didn't get to do that yesterday because I was finishing up some of the painting on it. And this brush, it has seen some things. Oh well. No brush is forever. We do what we can to preserve it as long as we can. Okay, wash time. A little messy and I'm going a little overboard with it, but it's fine. Fine for what it is. Like if this was a character, a mini, I wouldn't want to go this heavy with the wash. But it's terrain, so it's probably fine.
Come take a seat and I will recite you a tale of bold adventures spanning both sides of the veil. I knew a champion, we traveled far and wide. We saw so many wonders.
It's going from being kind of clean lines to very muddy. But it does bring out some of the texture and detail in the model, which is very much what the wash is intended to do. Well, that's good.
Into the deepest roads we ventured in the black. If we had only known what we were bringing back, we felt the fire of every temper, every mage.
Trying to strike a balance here. There's, I don't know if you folks can see it, but there's little cracks sculpted into some of these pillars. I'm trying to catch those with the wash without leaving too much wash behind. I don't know if it's working. Definitely worked there. I can go very heavy on the bricks. You want the wash to get down between the bricks there.
Just a lonely refugee, your champion arrived. Round shores of Fade to Kirkwall's buzzing hive.
really get the wash in there. Let the wash do the work. Quarter of the time that it took me to paint one side of the other thing. Just get the wash in here. We'll be going back in and doing some dry brushing, getting some highlights in here. So I don't. It looks really, really muddy now. But we'll be adding some highlights. So it will look less brown when I'm done. So that's that wash done. Let's do a wash on that little fountain. And then we'll do some highlights on that fountain, I think. Making progress. When I'm done with some of these minis, I want to show you, chat, I primed that orc, the pain boy, that I'm going to be painting for Community Art Day. And I want to show that to you, so you can see what it ended up looking like with the prime on it. I primed it in white, which is something I almost never do. But my intention is to do some very bright primary colors on it. So I figured priming in white was probably the way to go. Walk the garden, breathe the scent of life. Take this moment just to feel comfort in my tiny paradise, a place for lonely hearts to heal. And when forever face the pain that we are in. Eyes of grief are ever watching me. Lonely rooms and broken. Get some detail from the wash here.
Plants and plants to pluck the petals free, to drain them of their golden shine.
Out like the feathers here in the sculpt of this gargoyle. Nostril there on the beak, shape of the eye, all of that brought out by the wash. Obscuring some of the areas where I was less than precise about the edges of the paint here. This is where it gets trickier. Hold the mini from the bottom here. there. And we can set this aside to dry. And work on the other fountain. That'll do. Let's do some dry brushing on this one. My goal is to finish this piece today, this fountain. Finish a couple pieces each day, we'll be pretty much on target to finish a bunch of stuff by the end of this week. So, getting my dry brush out. We're going to switch over to off-white. Just to bring out a bit more texture here. Let's think about this. So as if the light source is coming down from this side here. A bristle of the brush. That wasn't what I intended to do. So that gives some texture to this and adds a little more brightness. Not. Not super subtle, but I think it works all right. Some of the gray rocks, I think, or maybe just a touch to the skull and bone that are inside the fountain. The stonework or the exposed stones here. Bits.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Now, chat.
For the most experimental part of this whole thing. We're gonna try and add some acrylic water. First of all, I need to open this. I guess. Yeah. Using a file to try and open this. I think it's working. I've got a drill around here somewhere. This might not be the right tool for this job, chat. Never worked with acrylic, so not sure what to expect here. Should I shake it up before I squirt it in? I don't know. Let's see. Oh, all the warning is in Spanish. No, here we go. Apply in several fine layers of no more than 3 millimeters thickness to prevent cracks or bubbles. Can be colored with model air or game air. Okay. Okay. Cause of eye irritation and skin irritation, so don't get it on my eyes or skin. Fine.
Let's see how that does. It's got a bubble in it there, but that's kind of cool, right? Should I add? I'm going to try and add just a touch of green to it to make it look like it's got like a layer of slime on top, maybe. See if I can do this. This is where it's all about experimenting.
They're still very wet. So I'm going to try and just add in a touch of green. Yeah, look at that, chat. That's kind of cool. Like algae floating on it.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
That could not be cooler.
All right.
Now we'll just wait for it to dry. Cool.
Oh, chat. That came out so well. I'm so happy with that. Let's go back to this. This is the one that I just did the wash on. And let's dry brush on some highlights. Fairly liberal with this, I think.
texture and definition to all of this. Make it less brown and muddy by adding a little bit of light to it.
Hello, Jen! Long time no see. It's going well. So I am done, Jen, with all the minis in the Warcry set that I have been working on forever. So now I am working on some of the small terrain pieces. I've just done a very, very liberal wash on a couple of these pieces. So now I'm trying to lighten them back up with a little dry brushing. Just so that they don't look so monotonous and brown. And Jen, I just did this fountain where I added a little bit of green into the acrylic that I've filled the fountain with. And I'm pretty happy with how that came out. It actually looks like the green is consolidated a bit, so I'm gonna add a bit more. Because I want that green to sort of permeate the top layer here. There we go. Just, it looks like algae floating on the top of the water. That at least is my goal here. Ah. Super satisfied with how that's coming out. Wait for that to dry and see what it looks like when it's dry. Exciting. So yeah, making progress. Jen, I don't know if you've been in my chat since you got your VIP badge. Oh, you don't have it. I thought... Oh, I did. You do. Yeah. You've got the VIP diamond there. Because you are one of the founding members of my chat. So... good to have you here.
I know you've had a lot going on. What with attending a wedding, and you've been, Andrew's crew as he was, sailing the seven seas yesterday. To this. It's less brown and monotonous now. And then I have one other detail that I want to do to this little wall. Actually, a couple of the other details. I want to highlight these bricks a little bit. And I hope this works okay. Thinking about this, I think I'm going to try and highlight them with the rust color, but I want to be subtle with it, so I'm trying to do just the vaguest hint of a rust color on these bricks here. A little bright. That's fine. Just to contrast them with the sort of the background there. What do you think, chat? Looking pretty good, I think. So now the final detail that I want to add to this. And I'm going to call this wall section completed. Is I want to add some moss to it. Let's move this out of the way because this is still wet. Okay.
my wood glue. Brush I don't care about anymore. And I'm just gonna try and decide where to do this. Brush some glue on here. Still sealed. My knife. This is spring undergrowth flocking. This looks. If I add a little bit of this in here. But I thought it would add some color. I kind of like that. Let's put some on the other side too.
Churches.
mashing it in into the glue in the hopes that it'll stay in some places. I've likened this stuff before to dryer lint, and that's very much what it is. It's green lint. But the end effect is pretty nice. Oh no! Shouldn't have blown with an open container.
All right. Well,
I think that came out looking pretty cool. Made a mess, but it's a cool effect.
Nifty. So, I've got two terrain pieces that are pretty much finished now. Finished this little wall portion here. I think it looks good. And we finished this little fountain. Just waiting for the
acrylic to dry. Hopefully the acrylic won't contract and crack, because that's not the effect we're going for.
But I think it's a thin enough layer that it should be okay. So this acrylic stuff, there's a lot of cool tricks you can do with it. You can make a sort of a fountain by layering it out in a line. And then you can sort of sculpt it a little bit and peel it off if you put it on glass or something like that. So that's something to play with. But yeah, two tiny pieces of terrain complete. And four more to go. How much time do I have? Like 5 minutes. Let's get a little bit of color on this, just in the remaining 5 minutes that we have. That was a productive session. And I am very pleased with the way that these two pieces have come out. I love playing with new things. And very much playing with that acrylic is new. Playing with the flocking is new. I love doing new things. And that's part of what all of this stream is about, is trying to do new and interesting things with paint and with modeling. And I'm so pleased that you folks chose to be here to hang out with me while I did it. So, as always, a huge thank you to you folks who have been hanging out with me in chat today. I promised you folks I was going to show you
the orc that I have been modeling for Community Art Day. So we're doing another Community Art Day on Monday, July 5th. I'm going to try and make it the first Monday of every month. We'll do a Community Art Day. And for this coming Community Art Day, I'm going to be doing some ambitious things with a Warhammer 40k orc that I've been modeling. So I built it on stream a few days ago, and I primed it at the store, so now it is ready to be painted. I also got myself a scenic base for it, so I'll show that to you in a couple of secs. Let me finish just getting a little bit of paint on this little piece of terrain. These tiny pieces of terrain are a great opportunity for me to experiment. So I appreciate that. That I get to play around. Try new things. Decided with these little Stormcast Eternal figures that are carved into some of these pillars, if I'm going to do anything with like the details on them. It's a decision I feel like I need to make at some point. Piece of flocking stuck in this. There we go. Just fished it out with the brush. Somehow all this flocking got all over my workspace. Don't know how that happened. Try and finish two more of these tiny, tiny terrain pieces. And then Friday I'll try to finish the last two. And we'll be done with all these. Can add them to the done pile. On some of the larger terrain pieces. Now that I've had some practice with minis and stuff, I wonder if I'll go any faster with those larger terrain pieces. Kind of hope that I'm faster now, but who knows? It's been a while since I've done any of the large terrain pieces. Took a break from them because they were so monotonous. But I kind of need to finish them. So, probably work on those next week. And then the week after that, I'll be working on that orc because, man, 4th of July is almost here, which means that the 5th and the remainder of July is almost here. So yeah, July 5th, Monday, July 5th, is Community Art Day, and I'll be working on that orc, and I'll encourage folks to post whatever art you're working on in my my Discord so that I can show it off to everybody else during that Community Art Day. It's all about hanging out, talking about art that we're all working on. Let me show you that orc now that I'm done with this. Man, I've got flocking all over my workstation. I have to remember, do the flocking last. Because, boy, does it make a mess. So yeah, this is, if I can open it, oh, I'm doing it wrong, there we go, this is the orc that I'm going to be working on during Community Art Day, is Pain Boy. He's got so many cool details, and it's going to be a lot of fun to play with. I also, this is a Necromunda textured base. I might glue some stuff to it, but that's going to be his base. So yeah, that is what I'm going to be working on July 5th. So I hope folks can join me for that. In the meantime, thank you as always for being here to keep me company while I got some painting done. It has been a pleasure, and I'm super happy with the pieces that I finished today. And I look forward to seeing you again soon, chat. We'll get more work done tomorrow. Tonight at 1 p.m., our friend Insidious Pie, I believe, will be continuing her adventures in Arcade Spirits. So tune in for that. 1 p.m. at Insidious Pie, twitch.tv/InsidiousPie. And then tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern, Amanda will be back at twitch.tv/merrymanlion to read more of Swallows and Amazons, tales of British children in the 30s having exciting sailing adventures. It's such a wonderful, wonderful book. Swallows and Amazons is so very relaxing and captures very much the imagination. So I hope folks will tune in for that as well. In the meantime, be excellent to each other, friends, and enjoy whatever art it is you choose to do. Thank you so much for joining me. Bye, everybody.